Have you ever tried to remove something in Photoshop with generative fill, and instead of removing it, you just get another object in its place? There's a new feature where this will never happen to you again. Have you ever had a problem when you go to remove something like maybe these people, and instead of removing it, it replaces it with something else? Well, let me show you this new feature, which currently right now is just inside of Photoshop beta. So you're going to want to go and grab that from Creative Cloud, choose beta, and then download Photoshop beta. All right, so we're going to quickly select these people using the object selection. And why don't we go under select people, so it sees those people, select them all here, turn on entire person, and then hit apply. That's a good way to get started. And then with the object selection, I'm just going to hit the shift key and then select some of these other objects and people. All right, so we used the quickest way to make this selection, but the problem is when we use generative fill to remove these people, in situations like this, when we've got very tight selections, generally we don't get a proper removal. What we do is we get a replacement with something else. So let me show you right now. So we hit generative fill and then just choose generate. And as you can see here, we've got these objects have been added. I'm just going to load the selection. So we're going to choose select, reselect. So we're going to use exactly the same selection we used before and choose a background. Now this time, instead of using generative fill, in the beta of Photoshop, we've now got remove. So this is actually going to use the remove tool. So a couple of things are happening here. One is telling it, hey, we actually want to remove, don't replace. And then the other one, once again, it's using the remove tool, which means it doesn't cost you any generative credits. And if we look at that, now everything has been removed exactly how we wanted it instead of generating other things in that area. But I want to show you something else in here. So here's another shot from my recent trip to Hawaii just a couple of weeks ago. I haven't processed this image yet, but this is a panorama from on top of the pillbox hike. So we want to get rid of the person. We also want to get rid of this concrete structure here and maybe this little bit of dirt as well. So why don't we just make a selection around this area and let's do traditional generative fill and we're going to hit generate. Okay, did a pretty good job. Let's go back and this time we're going to use the select. We're going to reselect. This time we're going to use remove. All right. And the reason I did that is we want to examine the difference between the two up close. So let's double click on a magnifying glass and we're going to go into 100% view. So if we look on here, let's go to the generative fill. And if we look at the generative fill, notice that we get the low resolution fill. Now, with the remove tool, we still get the low resolution, but if you look at it, it blends in much better when we're looking at this. See how that blends in so much better than this soft kind of thing going on here. So you can see for removing, it's actually going to give us a complete removal. It's also going to give us a better quality result, and it doesn't use generative credits. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful. Drop a comment underneath and let me know if you learned anything new. And if you're new here to the cafe, welcome. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And if you want to see what's new inside of Photoshop and Lightroom, check out this new video right here. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.